workout for this week. So your equipment that you're going to need is a band or some kind of pull-down setup. You'll also need a bench for when we get to our split squats. And you're going to need either a variety of medium-sized dumbbells or a solid set of medium-sized dumbbells. So we'll start you out with your ring of fire. It's all going to be oblique focused. So we're going to have one dumbbell here, which is also optional. And you're going to have a seat on the floor. We're going to do 10 Russian twists to each side. Once we get through those 10 Russian twists, we're going to move into our leg levers. So rolling into our back, legs are at 90 degrees, or we're starting to extend them a little bit straighter. We're going to lean over to one side, then pull through the obliques to come back in, and lean over to the other side and pull in. Last up here, we're going to do a side plank hip lift. The forearm coming down, feet are stacking up, drop the hip down and lift up, or bend the knee and go on a kneeling option here, lifting up and back down. All right, whichever one is best for your body. Moving on, we are going to move into your strength. We are going to be doing 2 tri-sets, so 3 exercises back to back to back, and then a little rest, and then you'll loop back in and around 3 times. Once you're done those 3 rounds of those 3 moves, we'll move on into our next 3. So to start us out, we're gonna do our close grip hammer curl. So we're gonna be here, curling in and back down. We're gonna shoot for 12 reps this time on all of our strength moves. Then we get to go into our split squats. So 1 foot up, 1 foot forward. We're gonna drop down and back up. 12 reps on one side, and then we'll switch over and we'll crank through those 12 reps on our second side. And then last up, we're gonna find our band that we've done our pull down at. And we're gonna either kneel or sit on the floor. And you're gonna pull your elbows straight down, squeeze the back, and come back forward. All right, once we get through those 3 moves, we'll take a little rest, then move back up for 3 rounds. Your next 3 exercises are going to be push for the upper body and hinging for the legs. So we're gonna start out with a hand release push-up. Coming into a high plank position here, core is tight, drop your chest all the way down to the floor, release the hands, and then press back up. Making sure to keep the core super tight so that your shoulders don't lead up and your hips stay down, and you just lift your body up evenly. Right? Making sure we don't worm our way up, and then it's a nice strong plank as you press up. If you have to do a regression to the knees to get through all 12 reps, that's also totally fine. Next up, we are going to take our medium-sized dumbbells and we'll move to our wall hip hinge. So finding yourself by the wall and then coupling just forward, hinging back until your hips touch, and then stretch out those hamstrings and come up. We're going to run through 12 reps, and then last up is going to be our Arnold press. So palms are going to be in front of the face, elbows stay high, rotate and press up, and then scoop them back around. Don't let the elbows drop down past the shoulders. Keep them lifted and engaged that whole time. All right, 12 reps on all those moves. We'll get through 3 rounds and then you'll be done. There will be a live workout offered for you tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. and 8 a.m. I'll be taking one of my finals for the semester. So Steph is gonna jump in and teach that class for you. And then she'll also make a recorded workout, of course, like we always do, in case you can't make any one of those time slots. I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend, and I hope you have a great start to your week.